In this video, I'm going to show you some of the most important gear that I use to make 51 Drones the channel that it is. I'm going to show you the cameras that I use, my lighting, my microphones, and a few other things that I found to be very useful for content creation. Now, this video is not going to have any drone content in it, so if you're here for a drone video today, then maybe skip this one. But for those of you that want to know what I use to make this channel, stick around. So let's get started. So it's very common for content creators, no matter what niche that they're in, to be asked what equipment they're using to manage their video production. Now, even though this is primarily a drone channel, it is no exception. Every so often, I get asked in the comments, what camera did you use to make this video, or what microphone did you use, because I want to start a channel and I want to know what you use. So the purpose of this video is to have a resource to direct people to when they ask about my gear in the comments. Now, everything that I discuss today will be linked in the video description. Now, first and foremost, my cameras. I use several of them to manage this channel, including the Sony a7C full-frame camera, and I have it paired with the Sony 20mm f1.8 lens, which is primarily my studio camera. That's what I'm recording on right now, and if you see me recording A-roll, you know, talking head video in the studio, that's what I'm using, the a7C. I wanted a full-frame quality camera with that low light performance, the good autofocus and all of that, but I didn't want to pay the typical full frame price. And so the A7C really fit the bill. And then the A7C is also the camera that I use when I want to go out and just shoot some photographs. Now the A7C is a great camera, but the workhorse of this channel is this right here. It's the Sony a6600, and I have it paired with the Sigma 16mm f1.4 lens. I use this camera for about 75% of the video content that you see here on the channel, and there are four major reasons that I love it. First of all, it's an APS-C camera, so it's compact and it doesn't take up much room in my bag, but it has a very beefy grip, and that makes it comfortable to hold and easy to carry around. Secondly, the battery life on this thing is phenomenal. You can record on this for about 3 hours straight, and you don't have to ever worry about constantly changing batteries. So that is so convenient and I love it. Next, and this pretty much goes for every camera in the Sony ecosystem, but the autofocus is extraordinary. I started this channel with a Panasonic, and when I switched over to Sony, I could not believe what I had been missing out on. The autofocus is like, I don't even know how to explain it. It's so, so good. And then also, and this is kind of an unpopular opinion, but I actually prefer the flip up screen to the flip out screen. And the reason that I prefer it is because when I'm recording and I need to check the screen to make sure that my audio levels are okay or my lighting is okay, and when I check the screen, if you have a flip out screen, you have to look over to the side a little bit. And if the viewer is watching that, they're gonna see you looking, you know, off to the side. Whereas with a flip up screen, you can just glance up real quick and see what's going on and get right back to the lens. Most people don't even notice that, but with a flip out screen, it's really noticeable. So I do enjoy having the flip up screen. Of course, the disadvantage is that it blocks the hot shoe mount. So if you want to mount a microphone or a light, you need to have a cage or a half cage like I have here from Small Rig. And that gives you two extra cold shoes, and that leaves the flip up screen unobstructed. The Sony a6600, it's the best camera for your dollar in my opinion. Now, a few other cameras that I use for things like B-roll and adding extra flair to my videos include this one right here, the Insta360 1X2. In my opinion, this is the best 360 camera on the market right now. It's got great video quality. It's got tons of editing features in the app. It's very durable and it's pocket friendly. You can just slip in your pocket. And then also it's waterproof, which is key for this family. I also use the Insta360 1R with a 1-inch sensor on it. I prefer this over my GoPro Hero 9 simply for the fact that the touchscreen actually works on this thing. GoPro video quality is great and hyper smooth stabilization is amazing, but they have some serious issues to resolve when it comes to touchscreen responsiveness. So I'm hoping to see them improve that with the version 10 that should hopefully be coming here real soon. And then finally, for my B-roll, I use my iPhone 11 Pro Max coupled with the DJI OM4 smartphone gimbal. And the reason I use this is because it allows me to get high quality slow motion with really solid stabilization. And so I try to get my B-roll to be as steady as possible. And with my phone and the OM4, I'm able to do that. Now, when it comes to lighting in my videos, in my studio, I use the Aputure 100D. That's what I'm lighting right now with. It's a daylight balanced polycarbonate light with a 95 plus color accuracy. So I never have to worry about any weird color cast or anything like that. It's super lightweight, so it's easy to move around. It's very bright, and I've never had to dial this thing higher than 30%. Like right now it's at 30%. But even when it's cranked all the way up to 100%, it is almost completely silent. It's like what Aputure did is they took all the best things from their more expensive lights, and then they put them in a plastic housing, which allows them to sell it at a much lower price point, and that appeals to a lot of prosumers like myself. Also, I can control the 100D with my phone using the Cytuslink app. And then right behind me here, I also use the Philips Hue lights for my accent, my background lights. And then I have these two little lights right here, these little tower lights, just to have off to the side. And I use them in many different ways, but I can control them with the Philips Hue app. So I can control all of my lighting with my phone or with my Alexa. And so that's really, really convenient. And then finally, my favorite light of all time is this thing right here. This is the Loom Cube Mini. This is an on-camera light that fits in any pocket, any bag, just about anywhere. It's super bright. It has exceptional battery life. I can mount it on my OM4 when I'm shooting B-roll, or I can mount it on any of my cameras on the cold shoe mount, and I can use it as fill light. I use this little, tiny little thin light for so many things, and Loom Cube is one of the best companies out there when it comes to lighting. Now, speaking of Loom Cube, they also recently got into the microphone game, and they just released this little guy right here. It's the Loom Cube microphone. Now, it may look kind of familiar. It actually resembles the very popular Rode Video Micro, which is a mic that I've used for nearly 3 years, but mine's getting pretty trashed. So I've been using this one lately, and it sounds great. It sounds just like the Rode Video Micro. It's super affordable. You don't have to worry about batteries. You don't have to worry about charging it. It's just plug and play. And I love that convenience. Now, the disadvantage of using a shotgun mic is that you need to stay in front of the camera. That is why for most of my videos outdoors, I use the Rode Wireless Go 2. Now, this mic allows me to move around freely. The battery life is super good. The audio quality, it's not perfect, but it sounds pretty good for a wireless system. And it's super portable. Like, that's the coolest thing about it, is that I can take it anywhere. You can transport it in your pocket, in any little side pocket of your bag. You can clip it onto your bag. So it's really convenient, and it allows me to make the kind of videos that I make. Now, my studio microphone is the Deity D3 Pro. That's what you're hearing right now. This shotgun mic gives me excellent audio quality, which I rarely have to do any editing on. All I ever do is a little bit of noise reduction to get rid of any room tone that may be in here, and that's it. And it's rechargeable by USB-C. It's made of very high quality materials, and it's super affordable considering how good it is. I put using this off for a very long time. Deity actually sent me this microphone a long time ago, and I put it off, and I just tried it one day instead of my Rode video mic. And I regret not using this microphone sooner, because the audio quality, the sound out of it is just so crisp and so clear. So Deity, really good job. Thank you so much. Now, I often get asked what computer I use to edit my videos with, and I have a PC from Computer Upgrade Kings. It's called the Mantis. It's a pre-built computer. I would love to build my own computer someday, but for now I don't have that kind of time nor the energy to do that. So I just go with pre-built. Now, I chose Computer Upgrade Kings back then, almost 3 years ago, because of their customer service and the reviews that they had. And I had a couple of issues the very first day, like when I was setting up my computer and I couldn't find the answer online on how to fix it. I reached out to them by email, and by the end of the day, both of my issues were resolved. And I think that's really important. So, like I said, this one's over 3 years old, and I'm going to upgrade by the end of this year. I most likely will get the updated version of the Mantis, because now it has the i9 processor, 32 gigabytes of RAM, and it comes with the RTX 3060 graphics card and 12 gigs on there. So that is going to be an amazing computer. But I'm also considering the Dell XPS 17 laptop computer, which looks like a super powerful laptop. I just watched a review by The Everyday Dad, and he's convincing me to move into the laptop world. But I think it may be just time to do that, because that's going to give me the ability to do things away from home. Like, I can do my video editing if I'm not at home. That would definitely improve my efficiency for video editing, but I just don't know if I'm quite ready to move into a laptop yet. So we'll see. But let me know down in the comments. Let me know your opinion. Should I get a laptop or should I stay with a desktop PC? Now, the last thing that I want to tell you about today that has helped me build this channel so much, it's not actually a piece of gear, but it's a website. It's a service. Epidemic Sound is the online music and sound effect platform that I've been using now for 3 years. And the reason that I got into it is because it is the most affordable platform out there. They have over 30,000 music tracks and 65,000 sound effects. It's easy to navigate and find the types of songs or sound effects that I want to use. I'm confident knowing that my videos will never be copyright claimed. And that is priceless, you guys, because one of the worst things to happen to a content creator is to have a video claimed, especially if it's a good performing video. Now, Epidemic Sound also offers a 30-day free trial, and that will let you download and listen to and try as much music and sound effects as you want. Before I got into Epidemic Sound, I would spend so much time searching the internet for copyright-free music, and it took up so much time. Plus, I always had that risk of a video being claimed, and I actually had one of my best videos ever claimed. So I was so angry. I just deleted it. I was so mad because that video was doing so well. Anyway, check out Epidemic Sound. They have some really great content on there. And I know that just sounded like a sponsored video or an ad for Epidemic Sound, but I promise you it's not. I really, really love Epidemic Sound. Like when I'm in my studio, I will listen to the music from there just for my enjoyment. Like not even on my videos, but I just like to listen to the music there. So as I mentioned, all of the things that I just talked about will be linked down below if you want to learn more about them or get them for yourself. Also, I'm going to post some reviews, some video reviews of some of the products that I just talked about from some of my favorite creators. I know that I didn't go through many of the specs for any of these things. I just wanted to let all of you know that were curious about the gear that I use. So I just wanted to get that information out there. But if you want to learn all the ins and outs and the specifications and things like that, go ahead and watch those videos down there. Hey, in the comments, what I want you to do is I want you to tell me what is the most strange thing that you observed while watching this video. Let's see how many of you were paying attention. Go ahead and click on that like button if I gave you anything of value today. Subscribe for future content. I've actually had a couple of emails this last week from some companies that I think you guys are gonna be impressed with. There's a couple of products that I'm gonna have the opportunity to try over the next couple of months, and I can't wait to show them to you. So subscribe so you don't miss those. I wanna thank you for watching the entire video today, everyone. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.